sir. Don't worry. You're in good hands. What's that? Okay. Let me move it down to the next one. What did you say that one was? Okay. Okay, time for your ride. Give me that letter. Wonderful. Let's see if you can read this to me. I know it's backwards. What would you expect? We're poor. I'm a pretty good cook, so I don't agree with that one. But it's for the funnies. Oh dang. Valentine's Day. Have you Valentine's Day to your pants pocket since it cost me more than you do? Salty. I'm sorry, you're out of throwback Thursday pictures from the year you packed. I wish my coworkers would give up talking to me for Lent. More like managers. I'm looking for someone who loves me in spite of who I am. That'll be for another video. I'm sorry you've reached an age where playing air guitar can cause an injury. There's a 75-year-old who did the tournament, I think, in the Japan, Switzerland, I don't know. I need a mental health day to recover from my mental health night of drinking. Happy Friday to someone who is absolutely amazing. You. Mind my ears. I've reached an age where falling asleep on the couch has nothing to do with coming home drunk. Absolutely. My couch is just so amazing. I'm extremely religious when it gets me out of work early on a Monday. Should do that. I work over 12 hours on Mondays. We'd love to have you over for dinner. And then wait impatiently for you to leave. It'd be really convenient for us to have a fling. Ooh, doctor. I know you'd be saying that to me, but I don't do flings, guys. The hardest part about making a budget is being honest with myself about how much I drink. Are you drinkers? I'm not much of a drinker, if I were to be honest. Thank goodness it's Friday because Sunday is 2 days away and I have Sundays off. Sorry, the only medals you have are the ones that say participant. Burn, baby, burn. Thanks for telling me about the 5% of your weekend I didn't already see on social media. My workout buddy is a picture of my ex. Ooh, dang, work it, girl. I can never stab you in the back because I'm too distracted by looking at your front. Sorry you had to come back from maternity leave to an even bigger bunch of babies. Ain't that the truth? This Friday, I'm going to have to work 12 hours because it's the last day of the month. I hope the extra hour of daylight savings gives you enough time to figure out why the hell we still have daylight savings. Nobody does better mediocre work than you. I could say that to a few of my coworkers. I'd like to reschedule. our date for a time when I'm feeling more desperate. Dang. Telling me to relax helps me forget about my stress and focus on my anger issues. Oh yeah. Doing that will piss me off. The complete plan is to stare at girls all day. Men. May your Friday be filled with joy. Or head rubs. Let's celebrate a proud Irish tradition by drinking shameful American beers. It's my roommate's birthday today. Dirty 30. I'm worried your complete ignorance of college basketball gives you a decided advantage in the office pool. May your devastating winter blues finally give way to your ill-beating spring allergies. Please tell me what I did that made you stop talking to me so I can keep doing it. Sorry, I've heard it in our shared workspace. Oh my gosh, that one should be for freaking management while we're doing it on purpose. Happy Friday to someone who is special. In love. Let's have a night away from the kids where we try to stay up at least past their bedtimes. Let's talk soon because I miss you hearing the sound of my voice. Sometimes that can be necessary. I love my cats as much as they love being indifferent to me. Please make yourself available to talk when I have nothing to do while driving. Life is like riding a bicycle because you're constantly getting in the way of more successful people. This Friday, I'm going to, you already know, I can't wait to hide all the Easter candy for the kids inside my stomach. That would be me. That is how I do life. Sorry, your attempt to form a summer softball team was a painful reminder that you don't have 8 friends. I don't think I have 8 friends. I want to break the company's HR policy with you. All I think about is having you inside me. Carbs. Every day. All day. Sorry, I drink tuna and I went really well together. If you want to be rich so badly, maybe you should start looking for a job. Oh, that one can go out to my ex. Here's to getting all my grocery shopping done for the week on Sunday, eating half of it by Monday. Actually pretty good about not doing that. Actually, I haven't been eating a lot lately. Thanks to Congress for teaching us that you don't have to work hard to play hard. Meditating is a practice of doing nothing and then bragging about it. My office crashes the vending machine. Our vending machine got broken by a coworker on Friday. Really great meeting you, but I'm currently not in the market for new friends. Maybe it's Thursday. whose holiday you're going to, go ahead and tell me in the comments. I'm brave in that I'll drink outdoors during a high pollen count. That's when you get local raw honey. I wish I had stolen a better umbrella from a coworker today. Rains a lot here too. I want to have a baby just so I can still hang out with my friends who have babies. No, I don't ever want babies. Mm-mm, not for me. Every day is hump day when I'm with you. Ooh, kinky. The closest I'll ever get at being famous is giving my baby a ridiculous name. Like LaDasha. Your Friday be filled with doggies. I'd rather unless you're allergic, of course, than cats. And if you're allergic to that, then cool animals that you like that you're not allergic to. I'd rather destroy the planet than carpool with coworkers. Yeah, I like racing my coworkers, so I'd rather just race them. I raced the Mustang today. And pretty sure I was gonna win, but I didn't want to get caught by cops, so I slowed down after a while. We were like neck and neck. This job is perfect stepping stone towards not fulfilling my dreams. Then he asked me to pull over, so I did. And when he asked me if I had a boyfriend, I lied and said yes. I hope we never get tired of making fun of each other. But luckily he was respectful and was like, okay, well, I hope you have a good night. I was like, oh, thank God. Not a creep. Just wanted to wish you a happy administrative professional day before I walk over and ask you to fax something for me. May your facial hair get the attention you believe it deserves. Sorry you can't make the rainy weekend go away no matter how many weather apps you check. I only exercise in the morning, so I have something to complain about for the rest of the day. Alright, I'm gonna end it there for that one. Chocolates from Hawaii from my mutual friend. And he wrote on in Sharpie on the chocolates. My motherfucker, Barry's motherfucking chocolates. He's like, stay away. Don't eat them. That was hilarious. I wish recycling was free. That costs money. such a good patient. Here's one of the rubbish too. I'm looking them up. So, I can test your hearing. And you seem to have pretty good hearing. Your eyesight is roughly 20/40. Which isn't bad. You survived the tacky doctor office, of course. I hope you experience the ASMR from it. I met someone today, a customer, who lives in a neighboring city. My uncle, Mamita. He said he would be back in a few weeks with his wife to show her the options.